Hi, Anti-Society! Welcome back to the Anti-Social Planet, and today we are checking out episode 240 of Bleach. And the last episode, we focused a lot on Toshiro and his zanpakuto, and honestly got me, like, a little bit more in my feelings than I was expecting, because, like, tiny Toshiro being upset about possibly hurting his grandmother inadvertently because of his Soul Reaper abilities coming through and having his zanpakuto, like, calling to him in his head was just a lot to me, and I had somebody mention in a comment that that was actually a canon story within the manga that they put into the anime, which I also think is great. I love that they would incorporate some of the other stories that maybe they didn't have time to cover or were like little bonus chapters and things into the filler, because that way there's still some of that canon storytelling being used. And also, it's a good way to tell those stories, even though they may not have shown up when they chronologically did in the manga and stuff like that. I'm still working through the manga, so I don't know all of those things yet, but loved getting to deconstruct Toshiro's motivations and why he's a Soul Reaper and things like that. I feel like because he's such a quiet and closed off character, we don't know a whole lot about him. Like, he doesn't want to talk about himself all that much. So I like getting any of the little pieces that we can, and just seeing like tiny Toshiro is just so adorable. But it looks like we might actually be getting into some of the stuff about Byakuya in this episode, which I'm excited for because he's just been gone for most of this arc so far. So I'll be very interested to see what he's been up to, if he's discovered anything. Talking about other quiet, closed off Soul Reapers that are in this show, I feel like Byakuya is also in that list. So getting to see what he's been up to will be very intriguing to me. And also giving us some more story about what his relationship is to being a Soul Reaper and his zanpakuto. I know that we learned a bunch of that in the Soul Society arc and things like that, but I think it's more getting to know about him on like a personal level as opposed to like his sense of duty and what he thought was expected of him and how he holds himself to those very high standards because of who his family is and that kind of a thing. So I want to see more of the like personal aspect of like the things that are more ingrained into who he is, of why he's a Soul Reaper, but we won't know until we see the episode. So let's check out episode 240. In 3, 2, 1, go. I'm still getting over a cold, so I apologize for coughing at any point during this video. The time of year. Ooh. So I bumped my mic, I apologize. See, going through this arc, just post learning some more stuff after the Thousand Year Blood War stuff that came out in the anime, just makes me more and more intrigued about what the zanpakuto lore is because of all the discoveries. I don't want to go too much into it for spoiler reasons. I don't know when and where people are going to watch this reaction, but for the people who know, it makes me more interested to get to more of the anime adaptation or the manga. I know I'm so behind on the manga, so I shouldn't even speak on like catching up on that because the chances are slim, to say the least. It's more likely that I will see the anime adaptation before I get to that part in the manga, but I can dream. I can be ambitious. I will say though that one of my favorite parts about going back through the filler is getting the nostalgia of the old openers. I'm already at that point where I'm like, they feel very nostalgic to me. Oh, it looks like we are getting some Byakuya. Let's go. I'm still like emotional. Again, Thousand Year Blood War stuff. We're still running off on our own, even though that's probably a bad idea. The fork in the road seems symbolic. Are we using the force? What? I guess, you know, kind of the force, if we're sensing spiritual pressure. See, I always turn right if I have to choose a path. Are we just like perching and lurking at this point? Oh, good, it's you. She just pulls out a giant blade. Sounds like a you problem. Don't like that Mayuri and I synced up there with our views, but I mean, like, if it had to be one of the Soul Reapers, I'm not that upset that we've chosen this one. When has she been able to do that? Are we surprised that Nemu has a lack of emotion? True. Yeah, I was like, I don't think that's what he was going for. I think he thought it might be a waste to not experiment on both of you the same time and see what happens. I mean, it is Mayuri. That man would. Has experimented on himself just to see. Oh, we figured something out then? I like that they're like on task and focused. Who was lurking that time? Oh, I guess that's true too, that she'd be able to like sense what Toshiro was going through a little bit. So I guess that was the wrong path. Should have gone right. Oh. Ichigo's just trying to figure out what's going on, and people keep on getting in his way. I love that shot where all the clouds clear back. Just real pretty. Pretty risky move, but worked out. Oh, look who decided to come back after the weird, all the weird stuff with Hollows. What's going on before? What are we saying? Awkward. Ichigo's just always like, "Yo, what's up?" when people show up to fight him. Get in line. How many people think that Ichigo will be useful for their plan at this point? He did figure out a little bit about how it worked when they were in his internal world with the like reflection, with all the like, I don't know, binds on the Hollow Ichigo. Unstable, that sounds dangerous. Not if your spiritual pressure is unstable. Ugh. Hello, backup. Not much of a talker. I was gonna say, isn't it Byakuya's? I think it's the spiritual pressure too. Like, they can sense someone's specific spiritual pressure, distinguish between soul reapers, so it's not just the technique. Oh, the way that she protected Momo. This is the person that was out there before? Byakuya, why? I thought they were going to be talking about his Zanpakuto there for a second, but maybe they did sense the his actual spiritual pressure. Can we talk about how Ichigo has been attacked by this attack like 3 times? And he like hasn't gotten a scratch from it? Like how impressive that is? I know he's like a shonen protagonist, but like still, dang. Predictable though, with his movements. I look how he's smiling. He's like, he's definitely having some fun. I guess it is. Is it? Uh-oh. I mean, I'm sure he's gonna show up in dramatic fashion. Ugh, I love the mixture of the color work. Both like the red, black, and the white, pink. He doesn't want to kill him, though. Ooh.
He's acting from a place of emotion now, though. More likely to make mistakes. Look who showed up to scold him. We got Matsumoto asking the real questions in this episode. She's like noticing things going, hang on a minute. Seriously, what's going on with Byakuya? Good shot, though. So that's a lot of information to have them standing at, like, either side. Yeah, I was wondering if some of the ideology, I guess, of why the Zenpakuto are behaving the way that they are would be something that Byakuya agreed with. It's true though, and if he feels like he is imprisoning his Zanpakuto by keeping it, then he probably does not want to do that because that wouldn't be in line with his pride. I don't know if m murder is the way that we should go to like fix that though. It is an interesting dilemma. I mean, we had Rikia before too, also releasing her Zanpakuto because she had a similar viewpoint of like, if the Zanpakuto want to be free, then we should give them that. But it's more complicated than that because there's some like altering of their emotions going on too. And I wonder how the Zanpakuto will feel about Byakuya siding with them. Like, it's one thing if he's kind of outside of the conflict, it's another one if he's like actively fighting on their behalf. And how that works into like their view of soul reapers and soul society at large. What about the rest of his squad, too? Do they have a similar view? He's not exactly communicating with them at the moment. And what about some of the Zanpakuto that have decided to go back to their Soul Reapers? I guess you would just see that as like free will. Ha Kameyuri's just like, great. I can do whatever I want now. They're so chaotic.
Well, I hadn't thought originally that Byakuya would side with the Azamukto, or at least their sense of freedom. I feel like there's definitely something more complex to what's going on from his point of view. And it looks like maybe in the next, like, following episodes, we'll get to, like, actually dig into that a little bit more. It does make sense for his character, though. I do understand that there is a little bit of a moral gray zone to all of this because it's a conflict in Bleach, so eventually we have to get to a moral gray zone because otherwise it wouldn't be Bleach. But there's definitely this feeling of, like, if this is what the Zanpakuto want, and we're seeing them as, like, actual beings that have their own autonomy and thoughts, then you have to, like, let them have that freedom, right? Like, you can't just take that from them and imprison them if it is, in fact, what they want. And then it becomes more complex because is it what they want, or is it something that is going on with the way that Muramasa is, like, manipulating the way that they're feeling? Because we do have some of that being talked about. We also have some of the Zanpakuto who have decided to be back with their Soul Reapers, and then other ones that don't seem to want to do that. So it is kind of all of these different things, but it makes sense. If they're each independent people with their own wants and desires, then they can have different opinions about this, right? Like, for all of the ones that want to be with their Soul Reapers, you know, Zangetsu, there's other ones that don't want to be with a Soul Reaper anymore and have a lot of animosity towards them, like Hizagi's, right? So it might just be that some of the Zanpakuto feel a certain way and some of them don't, and probably a bunch of them fall somewhere in between of, like, not fully being on one side or the other, and it kind of depends on circumstance and their particular Soul Reaper and how their Soul Reaper deals with this whole conflict that's going on. Like, it's a very complex relationship between these two sides, right, of the Soul Reapers and the Zanpakuto, because they've worked together and trusted each other for so long. But then what do you do when you find out that the person that you've been trusting and you thought that you worked really well with sees themselves as being, like, oppressed in some way? So I do kind of get that there is some complexity to that and where Byakuya might be. And I also feel like they're probably having it be this extreme show of what Byakuya is feeling or thinking because it's supposed to kind of have that shock value and it's supposed to be this kind of cliffhanger of him siding with the Zanpakuto. I feel like we're gonna go into more of the nuance and get more of what his thoughts actually are, whereas this one is just, like, them putting it in to be like, look, there's this other thing happening. But it does make me wonder if because they now know that about Byakuya, that there may be other Soul Reapers that either already feel that way or start to feel that way because they're starting to know more and more about this conflict. It's not just it has happened recently and we're reacting to it. Before, it was like they were getting attacked by the Zanpakuto, and they're like, obviously we have to get them back because we need them as, like, Soul Reapers, and they're attacking us, so we should attack back. Whereas the more they're learning about the situation, the more nuance there is to it, and I feel like it's going to become less of a immediate reaction to what's going on and more of them trying to reconcile the information that they're learning about their Zanpakuto with their own, like, moral code and things like that. So I feel like there's a lot of interesting things to come with this conflict. The whole thing in, like, premise seemed like it would be a very interesting conflict. So I like that we're exploring lots of different angles to it and getting to really see that relationship between specific Soul Reapers and their Zanpakuto and how they deal with that situation. So we'll have to see how this all works out with Byakuya and how the other Soul Reapers react to it, especially Arukia and Arenji, of how they feel about finding out what happened to Byakuya. So I feel like it's gonna be rockier and rockier as we go along, but you can click this playlist to go and see my previous reactions, or you can subscribe so you don't miss next time I post a Bleach reaction, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!